We give thanks to God that we are worshiping together today. Out of an abundance of caution, we are requesting that the congregation does not sing in an effort to minimize the risk of the spread of aerosols. We encourage you to sing in your minds and in your hearts. Thank you for your cooperation. Today in our liturgy, we celebrate the 21st Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider is our pastor, Father Peter Repcha. And we have Deacon Robert here. Please stand.
Thank you. people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on the place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shechem, master of the palace, I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day I will summon my servant Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash and give over to him your authority. He shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I will place the key of the house of David on Eliakim's shoulder, and when he opens, no one shall shut. When he shuts, no one will open. I will fix him like a peg in a sure spot, to be a place of honor for his family. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy empire. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. I will give thanks to your name because of your kindness and your truth. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. The Lord is exalted, yet the lowly he sees, and the proud he knows from afar. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. On the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God, how inscrutable are his judgments, and how unsearchable his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord? Or who has been his counselor? Or who has given the Lord anything that he may be repaid? For from him and through him and for him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
They replied,
Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed you this, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers and sisters, today Jesus is asking us the same question as he asked his disciples. Who do you say that I am? This is a very important question because, first of all, Jesus is asking his disciples who do they think he is for them personally. And of course, Peter's answers, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." But what is interesting in this sentence that Jesus is saying that this is not your words. This is the words that are revealed to you by your heavenly Father. And of course, if I ask you who Jesus is for you, probably you're gonna give me a definition from a catechism of the Catholic Church that he is the Son of God, the second person of the Holy Trinity. But we must realize that this must be our definition. Because in Peter's life, we can see later that he denied Jesus. Because as Jesus said, that was not his definition. Jesus must be a living definition that is written in our hearts. Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. In the second reading, St. Paul writes to the Romans about the judgments and unsearchable ways of God. "For from him and through him and for him are all things." We are reminded in the reading from Romans that God is the ultimate authority. It is God who is all, who creates all, and for whom all exists. Let us then, through prayer and especially by deeds, humbly and confidently acknowledge Jesus as the Son of the living God. Now, brothers and sisters, let us profess together our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. And I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, through whom all things
course, the love is eternal, so we have the confidence to bring our needs and the needs of our brothers and sisters before God.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church, may the Holy Spirit continue to strengthen us during this time of trial. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the whole world, may the Lord look upon us in His mercy and bring an end to the sickness and divisiveness brought on by COVID. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayers.
For students, teachers, and administrators, as they begin a new school year, may God watch over them and keep them safe. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who are enduring trials and challenges in their life, may they be helped by the loving presence of God and the support of our community. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the sick, the poor, and all who cannot be with us at Mass, may they find comfort in the Lord's mercy and love. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our beloved, that may they experience God's mercy and peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the intentions being offered in this Mass, for Jim Bolda and Christina and Adam Pauka, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
O God, through whom all things exist, we ask you to hear these prayers and graciously grant them according to your word, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
faith and entered willingly into his passion to prayer, and giving his thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, and saying, "Take this all of you and eat up it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving it thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Come quickly within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all the things we may please through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before the final blessing, I just would like to thank you for all your donations during these difficult times for all of us. Thank you so much for supporting our mission of St. Jacques de Paris. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.